Respighi's Nocturno has a 12-8 time signature, which can be a bit confusing or overwhelming. But if you will just remember that the left hand is actually keeping the beat for you, it gives you 12 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. If you'll remember that, then you shouldn't have any difficulties keeping the beat steady with this piece. The other section that's a little bit difficult is the interplay between the left hand and the right hand in the very first measure. Left hand plays an E flat, G flat, but then the right hand needs to grab that G flat to play it along with the B flat. So you just have to get used to getting off of the G flat. So it sounds a bit staccato-y. But what you want to do is try to connect the descending thirds from here to here and from here to here. So for that section where the G flat is shared, you'll actually play the first third staccato, and then the second one will come off of the G flat to allow this hand to get the G flat. And then you are free to connect the E flat to these two notes. So what that looks like with just the left hand is you just want to practice that until you feel really comfortable with that. And now let's put it with this hand. And when I add the pedal with it, just going to give you a smoother legato if you can connect as much as you possibly can. 39, we have two eighth notes spread over three beats on beats 10, 11, and 12. So a great way to practice that, put your metronome on at 40 and then line it up very slowly. Now let's try it a bit faster at 52. Faster tempo. And now without the metronome.